Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Bimal Jalan committee has recently asked RBI to transfer 1.76 lakh crore rupees to the government of India. Why and how did RBI accumulate so much of money over a period of time? Why did the committee ask RBI to transfer all this money to the government of India? Newspapers and news channels are covering only the first part, that is 1.76 lakh crore being asked to be transferred to the government of India. But the history and the conceptual clarity behind it that you want to have in order to be able to understand the committee's recommendations and also to have an idea about the questions that can be asked in the examination, I will be covering those things today. Let us start with a brief history about the committees on economic capital framework, and after that we will talk about the balance sheet of RBI and how will RBI be able to transfer this humongous amount to the government of India. The first committee that was created on this was V. Subramaniam committee, created in the year 1997. The recommendation of Subramaniam committee was that 12% of total assets of RBI should be kept aside as contingency reserves. The second committee which was formed was named as Usha Thorat committee in the year 2004. According to that committee, 18% of total assets of RBI should be held or kept aside as contingency reserves. In 2013, we had the third committee, which was headed by Y.H. Malegaum and called as Y.H. Malegaum committee. That committee did not clarify and said that adequate amount of funds should be transferred to contingency reserves out of balance sheet of RBI. And now we have the Bimal Jalan committee formed in December 2018, which has recommended that 24.5% should be the range of economic capital from total assets of RBI, and the range of realized equity should be 5.5 to 6.5%. These all numbers and the terms behind them look very confusing to you. So in order to understand what exactly these committees mean, let's go back a little bit and understand the concepts behind the committee's recommendations. So the balance sheet of RBI contains liabilities. Under these liabilities, we have reserves. The reserves of RBI can be divided into five parts. Number one, currency and gold revaluation account. Number two, investment revaluation account. Number three, foreign exchange forward contract valuation account. Number four, asset development fund. And number five, contingency fund. Let's understand these one by one in order to be able to understand how has RBI been asked to give 1,76,000 crore to the government this year. CGRA or currency and gold revaluation account forms a chunk of the reserves of RBI's balance sheet. It stands at 6.91 lakh crore in 2017-18. Now what is this CGRA? CGRA is basically the revaluation of gold and currency which means foreign exchange reserves. So whatever revaluation profits or losses the RBI makes is recorded under CGRA. As on now, the profits on paper or the reserves on paper of RBI out of CGRA stands at, as I said, 6.91 lakh crore. The second one is investment revaluation account. IRA says that whatever unrealized gains or losses RBI has made on the securities where it has invested, that is why investment revaluation account. So if RBI invests in rupee securities or in foreign securities, whatever unrealized gains RBI makes because of mark-to-market changes in the value of these securities are recorded as reserves under IRA. So these are unrealized gains or losses made by RBI because of change in mark-to-market value of the investments in foreign securities or in rupee securities. The third one that we have is called foreign exchange forward contract valuation account. Looks a little confusing, so let's understand it through an example. The example is what exactly happened in the past with RBI. RBI recently asked the banks to swap US dollars for INR, which meant that it went to the banks and said, banks, give us US dollars and take INR so that you can push liquidity in the system. Banks said, okay, but what we do if we need US dollars again? So the RBI said, okay, let's have a swap agreement instead, wherein today you give us US dollars and we give you INR, but 3 years down the line, we take INR back from you and we give you US dollars. That is called a swap agreement. Now, the problem is that the exchange rate fluctuates on a regular basis. So, what RBI did was that it entered into a forward swap agreement or a forward contract with another third party, wherein it said that, okay, let's have a contract wherein 3 years down the line, I will exchange US dollars that I have for INR with you at the rate of, let's say, 71. If the rate goes above 71, that is 72 or 73, then RBI incurs a loss, because in that case it will buy at the exchange rate of 71, but it will have to pay at the rate of 72. However, if it goes below 71, then it makes a profit out of it. So whatever notional or unrealized gain RBI makes out of these transactions is also recorded or are also recorded under FCVA, which is Foreign Exchange Forward Contract Valuation Account. The fourth one that we have is called as Contingency Fund. Please keep in mind that Contingency Fund is also called as Realized Equity. Now, what exactly is this Contingency Fund? Contingency Fund is a fund which is created in the form of a provision which helps RBI to meet unexpected losses which arise in the case of daily operations of RBI, like monetary policy decisions and exchange rate operations. It is notable here that contingency fund forms 25% of total RBI reserves. Having understood all these five parts, let's understand what Bimal Jalan committee says. Now it says that out of this 1,76,000 crore, 52,000 crore approximately is to be taken out of realized equity, and the remaining 1,23,000 crore is to be taken out through economic capital. What does it mean? Let's try and understand them. So, the Bimal Jalan committee says that realized equity or contingency fund should be in the range of 5.5 to 6.5% of total assets of RBI. And whatever excess RBI has should be transferred to the Government of India. If we take the lower bound, that is 5.5%, then RBI has to transfer 52,000 crore approximately to the government immediately. Similarly, the Bimal Jalan committee says that as a part of economic capital, which includes realized equity and which also includes revaluation account, if we include both these revaluation balances and realized equity or contingency fund, then the range should be 20% to 24.5%. If RBI has anything more than this range, then it should be immediately transferred to the Government of India. Now, coming to the valuation based on these ranges that have been created by Bimal Jalan committee, RBI has to transfer 1,23,000 crore as a part of economic capital, which includes both realized equity and revaluation balance, and it has to transfer 52,000 crore out of realized equity excess that it has. Now, let us take a question to understand what kind of questions can be asked in the examination from you. The question says, Bimal Jalan Committee on Economic Capital Framework has recently recommended a method to distribute profits of RBI to the government. Which among the following is the correct recommendation? Number one, realized equity to be maintained at 12 to 15% of total assets of RBI. Second option, realized equity to be maintained at 18 to 20%. Third option, realized equity to be maintained at 5.5 to 6.5% of total assets of RBI. Fourth option, realized equity to be maintained at 4.5 to 5.5%. And the last option, realized equity to be maintained at 6.5 to 7.5% of total assets of RBI. The correct answer, as you would have guessed till now, is C, that realized equity should be maintained at 5.5 to 6.5% of total assets of RBI. Very factual and easy question, right? Let's take up another question. The second question, which is again a very easy question, says, who among the following is the head of committee of economic capital framework formed by government in consultation with RBI? The options are A, Urjit Patel, B, YV Reddy, C, Viral Acharya, 4 or D, Shaktikant Das, and E, Bimal Jalan. Again, a very easy question, right? If you have read about it. The answer to this question is E, Bimal Jalan. I hope by now you would have understood what kind of questions can be asked in the examination from this topic and how easy it is to understand such topics if taken the right approach. If you like the lecture and you learn something new, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and share it with all your friends so that everybody is more learned every day. All the very best, take care and have a nice day.